When I was a kid, we had this one snack that my parents bought in bulk for our household. It was these tiny little pizza rolls filled with pepperoni and cheese. Now, these little pizza snacks were perfect for any time of the day. It didn't matter if it was 9 o'clock in the morning, 11 o'clock at night. These things did the trick. Something my brothers and I figured out was that there was a very specific way to prepare the snack that could actually totally change the experience. If you were in a hurry, you could pop those bad boys in the microwave and have them ready in just a few minutes. They would be semi-hot, soft, cheesy, and fill you right up. However, if you had some time and you were looking for a more refined, fine dining experience where you held up your pinky, then you could put the snack in the oven. Putting them in the oven required a lot more waiting with the preheating, allowing this delicacy to be fully baked, and then of course the time it takes to cool off before you put them in your mouth and burn the roof of your mouth off. Eating these after taking the time to bake them in the oven was so much better than using the microwave. Rather than feeling like soft plastic from the microwave's uneven heat, they would come out of the oven hot, crispy, and with so much better flavor. You could tell the difference immediately, and it made eating those pizza rolls so much better. The secret to the best tasting version of this mini pizza snack was more time and an oven. It just tasted better after taking more time to prepare it. And the same is true in our lives. The best things in life often take the most time. But here's the reality. You and I live in a world that is constantly trying to do everything quicker and faster and in a shorter amount of time. And that's because we want what we want now. We want internet so fast we barely even notice any lag. We want our food to come out of super fast at our favorite fast food restaurant. And it's so frustrating, right? When someone in front of us in line can't decide if they want a number three or a number seven, even though number three and number seven have been number three and number seven for years. We want movies, TV, and YouTube on demand, preferably without ads. And we want to finish our homework in record time just so we can chill and just relax. And most importantly, we want our favorite video game or movie franchise to hurry up and release the next one already. But those wants are usually the complete opposite of how our lives actually work. As we grow, we change in so many different ways. Sometimes we want to rush the process and get to all that being older means faster. Other times, we want to change things about ourselves, and we certainly want to change how much freedom we have. Sometimes, it's not even just about what we want. Sometimes it's other people's expectations of you. They expect that you'll learn something faster than you do, that you'll be ready and prepared to complete a task before you actually feel ready. Or they know you said that you follow Jesus, and now they expect that to somehow mean you won't ever make mistakes, or that your whole life will change right away. Think of it this way. Microwave popcorn is so easy to heat up and eat quickly. And microwave popcorn represents how fast we want important change to happen. We want it to be quick, fast, easy, and painless with zero mess. But wouldn't we all agree that while microwave food is convenient, cooking food over an open fire or a barbecue or grilling or baking in an oven would just taste so much better? It would be so much better than microwave food. The best food takes time and patience. Let's be real. So many of you, we fly through life. You go through the drive-thru, you grab your favorite meal, you grab your favorite chips, you grab your favorite soda, and all of that is good. It's convenient. But all of us look forward to that one or two times a year. Maybe it's a family gathering for you. For me, it was the holidays. I could not wait for my mom to make her mashed potatoes and for the turkey to be roasted. And here's the thing about that meal. It took so long to prepare. Here's the point. A meal like that, that's so good, takes a whole lot longer to prepare. And what you have is time and patience. You see, unlike microwaves, new phones, and new video games, the best kind of new changes, they don't happen overnight. According to Paul, who traveled around teaching other people about Jesus long ago, the new experiences in our lives take time to lead to change. In a letter to some friends who were at a church, Paul wrote this: anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone. A new life has begun. So from Paul, we learned that when we choose to follow Jesus, we become brand new. But like we've talked about, those changes aren't quick ones. It takes time for a tree to reach its full height. When I was in elementary school, there was a young tree in our front yard, and I loved it because it was me-sized at the time. Well, we moved away, And I wasn't able to see the progress of that little tree's growth anymore. But one time we go back to our neighborhood, we visited where I once lived, and we decided to drive past our former home. And my me-sized tree was so much bigger than I was. It felt like it had reached up to the sky. Even though I wasn't physically there to see its progress, I know that change didn't happen overnight. The same is true for so many things in life. The key word in what Paul was writing is at the end of that sentence. The old life is gone, a new life has begun. Begun. Not a new life happened already, not a new life and poof, everything is complete. Begun means that there's this ongoing process. It means that a new experience has presented itself, and from here on out, there'll be change. Every new experience is an invitation to change. New experiences are just the beginning. The thing is, as long as we have breath in our lungs, we are either at the beginning or somewhere in the middle of some type of change. In the natural progression of some weather seasons around the world, we don't go from fall straight to summer. We experience this gradual change from cool temperatures to even colder, then back to cooler temperatures again before we get to true summertime. The expectation that you or anyone else will be able to make important changes overnight is just unrealistic. But if that's the case, then what should the expectation be? How do you make sure the change actually happens? It's all a matter of steady practice over time. Just like the plants and animals around us change a little bit every day, practice allows us to change a little bit each day as well. So here are a few practices to start. First, practice praying. Praying is simply having a talk with God the way you would talk with others in your life. You can talk about what's going on in your life, the things you want or hope for, and you can ask God to help or be an encouragement to others. Next, practice hearing. Hearing from God is all about looking for the ways God communicates with you. Reading the Bible is one way to hear stories about what God has done in the past and what God could do in your life now. That's why making time to read the scripture on a regular basis is important. Next, practice talking. Talking is a chance for you to speak to other people you trust about wherever you are in your faith journey. Your parent or your guardian, small group leader, peers, pastors, and mentors are all people who can help you change and grow just by having a conversation with them. And lastly, practice living. When you prioritize talking to God, hearing from God, and talking about your faith journey with others, then you can be open to discovering the things you can do to live and everyday faith. When we put these things into practice, we begin to look more and more like Jesus. And that's the type of change that shapes you into a new person a little bit each day. Putting into practice is a chance to be a part of the new that we read about in Scripture. It's how you can continue to grow and change once that change begins to happen. Little by little, our wants and our desires begin to look more like what God wants and what God desires. What God cares about becomes what we care about. That's the gradual change that can happen because every new experience is an invitation to change. When you head to small group, think about what can be the next best step you can take on this journey.